Okay, so I should be talking right now. Audio levels, audio levels. Yo, okay, sorry, I was, I muted my microphone. So yeah, like I said, welcome to Ape Escape. Where the apes escaped and we're trying to catch them. And we're doing that in a timely manner, and there are some glitches in the room that I also wanna show off, but c'est la vie. So, the story about this game, let's say that first, is that this is Jimmy, or Hikaru, and almost, well, he did something stupid. And what that stupid thing is, very good left ear audio, I can fix that as well. Yo, right channel got nothing on me. Heck. Well, he sent some Peepo helmets, or those monkey things, you probably know. Monkey things, monkey helmets. They're called Peak Point helmets, the same one you see on screen right now. And they make the monkey smart. Unfortunately, the smart monkey also got one and wants to take over the world. And here we are to stop them by catching them and making them unescaped. That's really it. So as any game, no game is without glitches. There's a really cool glitch in this level as well, and I hope that I can still get it. Seeing that I actually miss a boat. Yeah, there we go. So what happened there is the trigger? The trigger for the net goes through walls and ceilings. So, what happens? Game audio is too loud. Okay, I can fix that as well. Thanks for the feedback, boys and girls, if they are there. Resets on life. And that's how I got the monkey through the bridge. Okay. Now that everything is, like, alright. I got a new emote for this level. Which is OLE! I don't know why, but I really think it's funny. And the story about this game as well is where in Ape Escape 1 they went back in time to change history to make it so that monkeys rule the world like forever. Here it's so that they're going to places that are in present day. And actually, I need to time this, nice. That they were already here always, but obviously that's not gonna work. I mean, here they are in Spain, I believe. Yeah, Ole is Spain, there are Tauruses here, and this is really Spanish looking, if you ask me. But yeah, enough about like the story. I mean, we're skipping over it anyway. Wow, that was a good monkey. Where is... there he is. It's RNG where this monkey is, and so is every monkey, by the way, that are all RNG. But yeah, there are 5 monkeys who are special, and they got a lot of performance-enhancing bananas, or Fida Z bananas. Say hello to the first of the Freaky Monkey 5. This is... Blue Monkey. And his special power, as normal blue monkeys, is speed. So he got like a motorized unicycle, and that's how they... And that's how he goes fast. Instead of running fast. Wow, what a loser. So we're forcing him to go into this pattern, because those bridges will collapse in a little bit. They will be like yellow and then red right now. So he won't go over them, and we can manipulate him into going a certain path that's that's really favorable for us. Oh yes! Yo, this is like the perfect blue battle. Like, I don't know how to get him near you except for what I just did, I guess? Yo, Milkus doesn't know what's happening right now. That's pretty cool. And because this is like the spooky marathon, we're also going to like a spooky level. So that's this. And I kind of forgot level of this. A Castle Frightmare. This is like a horror level. So, casually getting this white monkey. You can throw bombs, by the way. Oh, rip. And normally we're not supposed to be here, but with a perfectly timed boost jump, we can go over this ledge and go through the level backwards, which we will do like a lot. Also, more swag tricks, a double catch with these two professor monkeys, I guess. And well, yeah, let's just say that there's a lot of optimizations that you can do in, like, in this game. So we got that monkey. That's what I should probably do from now on. Yeah, it's threat thinking life. So if I will not get hit for all these bananas, I can get this monkey before he sees me. And yo, get this Mona Lisa monkey. Yo, we're ahead again. Our audio levels are right now, by the way. Yo, saving the marathon life as well. Okay, so Fighta Z Factory. This is where all those performance enhancing bananas came from. But we're not going to see them. However, this level is home to like the biggest skip in the game. No, it's not the biggest skip, but the latest. Like, what's happening? Normally you go through like a passage of hallways with a giant robot. And although that's really cool, yeah, let's say that it's boring and not many monkeys there. However, what I just tried to do and failed a little bit is fight a Z skip with a long jump, and yo, I actually got it. So catch this monkey here. It's a light blue monkey. He's pretty sad. Catch this monkey and let's go into that robot that I spoke about earlier and fight against this guy. And you can see the speeds that we're walking with. This whole skip saves roughly, yeah, let's say 2 minutes. I'm serious about it. But yeah, it's not the easiest thing. There are other ways to get it, even a backup way that kind of almost always works. But I'm happy I got it second try. Okay, enough about that. We're now going into Casino City, which is like a really cool place. And except that it's like a casino, we're also getting the slingshot. And for those that know Ape Escape, the slingshot is broken in almost every game. In the first level, and I'm gonna talk about slingshots mostly now. In the first game, oh yeah, before catching monkeys, we're going this way first. Because we need explosives. But yeah, in the first game, the way how the slingshot was broken is that if you like jumped and went into shooting mode at the same time, then you could like infinite jump if you do that multiple times in succession, and it's pretty easy. And in the second game, this game, they fixed it, actually, by... what they did? Oh yeah, you can't get, shoot the slingshot in third person, so you need to go in first person. But there's another glitch. So what can you do when you're in first person? You can crouch. But what if you jump and crouch? Then this happens. Basically what happens is we're elevating, and with that we're basically able to just fly and skip giant portions of levels or do unintended skips. That was slow. That was slow as well. Okay, I missed it. And for some reason, I'm really not consistent at it. See, there I got it. But yeah, it's basically you jump, you go into first person mode, you crouch, and then you go out of it with another jump. And that's within a second. I mean, anyone can learn it, but... this controller has had its days. And now we're going to an... ooh! Ninja level. Or ninja hideout. And one of my favorites... favorite gadgets in casual play. Not so much in... yeah. Fast play, I guess. The RC car, which is especially, well, exactly what you think about it. It's a radio controlled car. Yeah, what can I say? That monkey must not see me, so that I can catch him easier. Okay, yep, this guy. Oh yeah, this is almost kind of a PB attempt. I'm not gonna go into details, but last time I played, I got like a godly run. And I messed it up at the end. So this is PB material, maybe. Maybe. So we're using the car here, and maybe we can even drive over the... no, we can't. He destroyed our car. Nice. He's a nice guy. Something else. Like, I think I said like the most important stuff already. There are some more glitches later on. This monkey is not moving, since normally you're like supposed to like get that thing out or press the button so that the whole platform there falls into the ground. Well, thank you, owl. But because we didn't do that, obviously nothing is gonna work. Okay, apparently we're maybe getting Jet Set Radio in an hour, or after my run. That's cool. Oh yeah, this is the best monkey, by the way. Look at that shot. Full buttocks. Yeah, this is yellow monkey, yeah. And he ate a little bit too much, as you can clearly see. I mean, I'm not judging. But yeah, he's like the clown monkey, I guess. And yeah, I also don't know his gender. There's a lot I don't know. It's a problem. Yeah, luckily we can like manipulate him into attacking pretty quickly again after after falling, or after hitting him. So now he goes to the pole. Oh yeah, you also see me use these explosives that I picked up in Casino City. Explosives do a little bit more damage. Like, I don't need to use it here because he's not dead, but they do a little bit more damage than regular hits, so that speeds up the that speeds up the fights, like by a cycle. Yeah, he's a sumo wrestler. You're right. And we're gonna use that in some other places as well, especially now that the car route is found. Like, there's a relatively new strat for the final boss. Yo, that ceiling. And now I can use it anymore. Okay, whenever I see this level, I cry a little bit inside. Why? You'll see in the next screen, I guess. Oh yeah, shout out to Gigen Hamatan, I guess. Okay, so this screen. This is a giant mountain. And at the top of the mountain there are like, if I can make it, there are six monkeys who are all going down at the same time. Can I get him still? No. Doesn't matter, there are still two monkeys here. Yeah, we missed the other snowball. But yeah, they're all coming down at the same time and it's really awful. Unfortunately, I didn't get my height. I didn't get my height hovers correctly. I don't know, Pac. How does it feel to be running in a big league marathon? It's an honor. Then again, I'm also kind of the guy who sets most of the technical stuff up. So, cut me some slack. Yeah. It's cool, especially now doing it an hour earlier. Also, shout out to Pac. He's a cool guy. So, and here we're also getting one of my favorite gadgets. The Sky Flyer. Yeah. Things is gonna be lit whenever Dijon Ham is like, is going to be an IRL marathon, if that's ever gonna happen. Like, who knows. So, this monkey just jumped down after not jumping down. I missed. So there's not too much to tell about like this level, I guess. Except that this level introduced like red monkeys, and as you can see, they're pretty aggressive. Like, they're ready to fight all the time with their boxing gloves, I guess. This monkey like literally jumps into my net. Shoutouts. Kelly to the rescue, oh man. And we get that monkey with like a sweat catch, which is really cool. Alright, we're actually on good pace right now, but will that stay? So, for those that missed their daily dosage of Super Mario Sunshine, actually, we're gonna fix that for you, because this is the Blue Baboon! Just like the most visited beach like ever in Apeland. I don't even know what country this is. And that power-up that we just got, or the gadget, is a banana ring, which is a banana boomerang that has banana scent in it. And with it, you can lure some monkeys, which we'll see in a little bit. Yeah, can we get this one quick? You need to be like real quick to catch him before he notices you. Wow, Toast, awful. Catching this monkey. He's Ryan, by the way. Unfortunately, I'm like on the Japanese version, so there are no names. Which is like a big thing, unfortunately. However, the Japanese version has one really big difference that just justifies the cost. Except that it's like the mid version, where US in the NTSC or USA version, you see the monkeys see you from further, so they'll spot you easier, which makes it more awful to catch the monkeys. On PAL, it's easier. However, here on Japanese, the only reason why we're on Japanese is fast item switching, where we have to go in like the menu for item switching. Here it's just simply, if I want another item on the circle button, I just mash the circle button. Also, I did awful there. Second hit. This is the second hit. This is Pink Monkey, by the way, and she... Pink Monkey, she just wanna perform. However, she quickly finds out that you're here to catch her and be not nice to her. Now she's mad! And I stood in the correct corner. Yay, balls. Come on. There we go. Yep. What? Okay, I don't know what happened, but basically she just ended the cycle and started a new one. Yeah, where's RC car? So that normally happens with the beach balls. It's weird. And it sucks because I'm gonna lose some time because of that. So maybe I can get like a cookie from here. That would be cool. No cookie for me. So that's why I made the emote, because Pink is giving me the suck. Especially now that with that extra cycle and doing the slowest attack ever. Shout out to Pink. So this is not gonna PB. Doesn't matter though. So now we're not getting new things for like a little while. New gadgets. Why do I keep forget the words gadgets? Okay, now we're going to enter the monkey, and just as Snowball Mountain, there are like 7 monkeys here, and they will all see me at the same time, and they will all run to different places, I guess. So monkey management is a word and important. Also, how I totally failed getting this monkey. Screw that monkey, we'll get him later. There's a second chance to get these monkeys. Where's the other one? Yeah, too late. We're getting these monkeys later, I guess. Monkey management. So yeah, what works for me is like getting the red ones first, since they're the most aggressive. Afterwards, I don't know. So, then there are the spike balls. to completely avoid them, I have to start the death loop while standing still, so that I don't like stutter over small things. So get this monkey from the face, and we're done here. And don't forget these monkeys, which I have done before. Like, oh, I'll catch this monkey later. And then, yeah, I don't catch them later. And then I'm like at the end of this level and like, what, another monkey? Yep. So, this is our, I believe, our second instance of going out of bounds. And, well, there's a lot of that. We don't see it here specifically. Also, yo, the monkey didn't see it. There's a lot of going out of bounds. So this is Bruce Lee. And every monkey here, by the way, is... or most of them is called after one of those martial artists. Oh well, free catch. Except this one. Developers gave this guy a gun, and boy, does he know how to use a gun. Right next is one of the... bigger, complicated, not so fun to navigate level, Simian Citadel. And this level is a giant circle, which means that, well, you go and you land here in this room. However, we're speedrunners, we're glitching it up. And we're just going to like the ending to begin with, since there are like four monkeys that will give us the edge of not having to do the annoying swimming section. So this is a blue monkey, and if he sees us, he will run to that what you call it? UFO ship. And let's say we don't. Whoopsie. I see that wizard monkey there, and that's bad news, since that's from a bonus disc I'm not normally allowed to have. And, well, it's only giving me, like, some knockback. So it actually costed me time. Run is still valid! World record in Ape Escape, yeah, I wish. The current world record holder is like still going at it. And he's mental, by the way. In a good way. Okay, so we made first cycle. Where's the monkey? He's on the left, which is not great. Actually, which is bad. He didn't come far. These spikes weren't solid, but this thing is. Okay, I'm going to do scrub strats here. I don't have time to actually start the dash loop again. Yo, this controller is broken. I'm blaming it on my controller. There we go. So, some manipulation here, getting this monkey to shoot already and not go all the way over there. I hope that I found it. No, that's me with Goat Simulator next. And here we're going to do a glitch, which allows me to actually warp down and catch the monkey here in the cage and fly back out. Those are actually two different glitches. The one of them like remembers where you are on the ground and transports you the moment you like use Skyflyer, and the other one just basically, if you catch a monkey, you go up a little bit. That's what we're abusing. Yeah, Kitsune, I like running this game. I definitely like running this game. So now we're going to one of the easier late... Can you call this late game? Yeah, late game levels. Simply because there's not that much going on, other than some platforming. So this monkey also has a gun, and luckily he didn't appear this time in my book, which I like to call, who the hell gave this monkey a gun? This level has some quality going in from the behind, or going backwards. That's more kid friendly, I guess. We're going like over this wall to this forsaken piece of land, I guess. So let's get the cookie, which is here. It's pretty cool. Yo, if I can get him like right now, cool. And then we death warp back to where we were. So, monkey. And now we have to get out of here. But there's still like three monkeys. Three? Two? There's still a few monkeys here. Don't worry about it. Normally you have to like use the RC card to get him. And again, going in backwards. Oh, rip. So there we go. Since there actually is a monkey here. And that's all we came for. This monkey was like, yo, you can kiss my butt. Because he was standing in a room with trapdoors. Unfortunately, they're like a little bit slow to like do stuff. Nice skeleton mohawk piggy. He bumped me in a cookie, so I actually gained like half a cookie of life from him. Okay, time for the white monkey boss battle. So since there is the new boss battle route, we have some explosives to spare since we don't use them in, well, the final boss anymore. So it's actually faster by one cycle, which is 15 to 20 seconds. Let's say 15 seconds. And I'll save it here. But yeah, this is White Monkey. And he is the brains of the operation, I guess. And he thought, hey, this guy is catching all the robots and defeating us. What if I build a robot? However, he has like a weak point on his back, and I don't recommend building weak points on killer robots. Anyway, I do have to watch out since I have only 3 explosives and I need all 3. What I'm doing here with him is... Yo, I got him. Is, well, I can, with my spinny finger, I can hit his... I can hit his weak point through his back, basically. And he also has a spinny dash hoop. Yo, can I hit him? Nice. Okay, now we can hit him with like a normal stun clip. That should be it. This boss can be difficult since you can easily miss the explosive on him. And that will revert you back to like 5 lives. Or 5 cycles, but it's not that hard of a boss. Even casually, I'd say. You just need to know how to evade his attacks. So, we're now going to Paradal. And here we're getting the most useless gadget we can get. The flamethrower. Not the water. The water gun. That's like a completely different thing, but whatever. Yeah, the water gun. So first off, these monkeys. They're pretty cool. They're like titanicking there. I might have a problem there. Yeah, okay. So this guy likes to shoot out of cannons. I don't know why. But monkeys need to have their hobbies. But yeah, fire! We need a water gun. Or we can just damage boost through. Speaking about damage boost, that's something that we're gonna do like a lot in both this level. Rip. And the next one, even. Oh. I fought the enemy there. It was the monkey. Yo. What was that? Oh well, we can also do this. Doesn't matter. So, shout out to this monkey. He's got dick. But obviously you can't read it on Japanese. Got a cookie here. And there's this fire-breathing monkey, which honestly never have breathed fire since I'm running this game. So he needs to rethink his special talents, I guess. And here's another robot. This time a monkey robot with a chainsaw's hand. So although I haven't been a part of the community for long, like the beginning of this year, apparently in the beginning of times, they were fighting against that robot. Like first the hands, then the back. Then repeat that 3 times. But apparently the demo of the game tells them how to speedrun the boss. And with that I mean like literally if you don't do anything at like the start screen, then they will show it to you what you need to do. Good guy developers, by the way. There was some girl like someone screaming outside. I hope it's not. I hope nothing is happening there. Anyway, this is the land of the apes. And it's all snowy. And there's nothing really much to be here. There's like this damage boosting here. Catching some monkey and ice physics, because every good game has ice physics, at least somewhere. Yo, this monkey. can be super awful if they catch you before, because that will certainly waste time. I'm here, so I'm taking this route. Also, this game is like custom routing, I guess. Where if you end up at the one space, you're going into the other area, or just here. This is the most relaxing area. This is a sauna. You can see this monkey, green monkey, even though he normally should have rockets, he's just there. Not even his pants on. He's like cleaning his back, or drying his back. Just relaxing. Relaxing. They were doing stuff. Let's keep it at that. This one is trying to put on his pants. Because monkeys are cool. Okay, fine. Fine, we're going this way. I didn't mean to actually do that, and this might have been slower, but... Hey, custom routing. Or on-the-fly routing. So although we're, on my timer at least, we're 117 behind, we can still PB. I mean, I can still get a new personal best. That's how much I messed up. So like my goal is getting a time beneath the 1 hour mark. That would be cool if I got it. Okay, the Lost World. Which is also a Sonic title. And there's this monkey. Who's hopefully not going in my book of who gave this monkey a gun. And he didn't. Yeah, this guy can like shoot you off. Oh, I missed. Great. This guy's called Homer, by the way. Or Homie in the American version. So can I? I don't know what this. Really? Monkey just flashed me. Like happened last time as well. Oh yeah, he throws bombs. Good guy. I mean the camera angles here, since that's makes it so that we can use some lag reduction. So. Just catch him. Whoa, that never happened before. That never happened. I was knocked off by one of those skull piggies. So where's the monkey? There he is. I feel bad for these monkeys though. He was like just in his living room. This guy is cleaning himself with graphics. And this guy is like watching TV or Game of Thrones, I guess. When I catch him abruptly in his house. I'm a bad man. Can I get this guy as well? Nice. In some occasions, the red monkey was like super aggressive and already tried to hit me. Yo. Also, hey, it's a T-Rex. He knocks over the yellow monkey just to be safe himself. Well, next to not being like a good friend. That makes it even so that I can... Yep. Don't jump. That's my job. That makes it so that we can catch all three monkeys like super easy. So again, some out of bounds action. Going catch this monkey here. Without him even seeing me, nice. Spooky over here real quick. And shoot this guy out of the air. And that's that. And now we're finding the last monkey of the Freaky Monkey 5. And after that we have fought against every one of them and caught all of them except for the yellow monkey. Which I didn't really say, but the yellow monkey, he just... you're not gonna touch me. Or catch me, I guess. And... well, yeah. He just jumps away and I'm like, what? So yeah, this guy, I hit him once and he's like, no, I'm mad. I can't win, so he just grabs a T-Rex. Yeah, he gets so mad, he grabs a T-Rex and body slams it into the arena. Can you guys say that as well, that you've ever done that? Like, body slam a T-Rex. So, come on, do it once more. One more hit. Oh shit, he is doing his attack. So, normally he doesn't do this, but like in really rare occasions. Oh, apparently Skelly Cat literally does it every morning. So I'm just weird. And I can do this buzzing sound in only two cutscenes in the game, so... you have to say sorry. Okay, so we're going into the last level. The last monkey level where we have to catch monkeys. And we get a really cool, but not that much used item. A giant magnet. What can you do with magnets? Well, you'll see later. Why is this monkey here? Yo. That monkey was a clone. Yo, catch this guy. After that, fly. Did you see that? Okay. So this monkey didn't even see us. If he saw us, he was like running around everywhere. That was really cool, by the way, just walking over that thing. I've never done that before, TBH, but I just wanted to try it out and. Lo and behold, it works. So this is like a really big building. I don't know what they do in this building. So there's like a super big lobby. Like someone who enters the gate. Right after here, it's super dark and you're basically in the sewers. So, and this monkey is unfortunately not next. Not really close to the window over there. Sometimes he does that. And then we can catch him. Okay, whatever that was. Now we can catch him through the window. Because, as seen in the third level of the game, the... like the trick, the load zone.
Load zone?
Can I still make it? No, I can't. So normally we like use a magnet to get stuck to there, but I messed something up. Was too late. And also I need to get like the banana ring. Wow, nice sliding physics. Yeah. Now get the Sky Flyer. We're almost out of this Suri area. Or not walk off, thank you. Okay, so there are like 5 monkeys left. 4 monkeys left. That monkey there could have given me like a lot of trouble, but he didn't today. Thank you for that. So yo, frogs. There we go. So instead of doing this tank section, if you know this game, you're going to use the tank like a lot over there. But how about we just skip it? And fall down here. Not make it. And get spawn a tank here. So me actually not making it. Part of the plan. Yo. Get this guy as well. We have one more normal monkey to catch. And that's that one. Through the ceiling again. Kitsune, that won't be a thing anymore. I'm sorry. Okay, so now we're going to like the base of the enemy, the base of Spectre, which is the bad guy that I spoke about earlier, I think. Well, he's the bad guy, take it from me. So we found out where he is. He's a code Chimp, or C-H-I-M-P, I don't know what it stands for. But just as any other level, we could go through it. So that was a nice boost flyer. Yeah, we could go through it. Or we just go to like the end. And the door that we just came through, we're going through it again. And we're already at like the boss of this place. Remember this guy, Yellow Monkey. Whenever he fled from us, he went to the Fighter Z factory, ate a lot of performance enhancing bananas. Fighter Z bananas. Do I have explosives? No. And he became this big. And instead of like doing the smart thing and actually killing me, he plays with me, and let's say he's a big dummy for doing that. So this sound effect is really cool. Okay, so this attack, which I can only do like a few times. Getting hit here makes him stop doing the attack, so it's faster to get hit. Unfortunately, I only have 2 cookies left, and it does like a whole cookie of damage. If you saw me like only getting rid of like half of a cookie, that's how this damage system works. But that doesn't matter. For now at least. So, did it just throw off one of the piglets on its own? Yo, I missed the tooth. Okay, it's one more tooth left. And he's going to be awful. So he's going to do 2 attacks right now. The same attack. Shoutouts. Yo, somewhere in the vicinity of... Actually, never mind. I should have just evaded it because now I'm like only have 1 cookie. then that's yellow monkey. 5 teeth. When is 6 teeth? Sunshine joke. Or Super Mario Sunshine joke, obviously. And this is the second level. I'm so sorry for your ears and everything else. I'm actually not. Anyway, it's now time to go to the final boss. Spectre. Because apparently he's on the moon. That's where all... that's where all things go to, I guess. So, get my equips right. Yeah, this is what I want. And hopefully don't mess it up like in my personal best. Speaking of which, it's not gonna happen today. But that's not a problem, since I just wanna show like what this game is and how cool it is. It's like catching monkeys. It's cooler than that. Yo, I didn't do this trick correctly. No? Yeah, no. I didn't softlock, I just was in a transition. So, skipping all the cool cutscenes, which I prematurely kind of wanted to do. Here's the first boss! Or robot form. Since Spectre loves mechanical suits. Yo, he drops helpers who can drop like cookies. I see two cookies already. So here is where those new threats come in. I have this car here, and if I blow up this car, the explosion of the car is stronger than a normal explosive. So if I blow up the car, it does more damage to him than any of my items now can do. These lasers, by the way, that you kind of want to jump over with the Skyflyer? Yeah, let's not. Okay, that's the first phase. Now we're going to the final phase, which is another monkey suit. And Skelly, time is coming up in 2 hours. 2 hours, 2 minutes. So I also need to get rid of that thing and use a magnet for the final battle. Who knew? So the strat here is to drop like a car and make the him actually blow up the car so that we can get out. Unfortunately, we didn't do it really well. So I just got hit there. Normally I'm like supposed to fly over, but I don't know what I did wrong. But that's exactly how I lost my my big PB. Just sad, but true. I'm gonna try the old way. Let's see if that works. Yeah, I should just do that. Okay. So now the gates are getting closed. And he only needs one more hit, and we are not gonna do that with the car. So it's giving me the slowest attack again. So yeah, the RNG in this fight, which is a thing by the way, was really bad. Okay. we're gonna do rockets, and timing is coming up soon. And time. No, wait, no, not yet. You can undo it, but doesn't matter because it's time. Sorry, Skelly. Yeah, 101.35 on my book. Anyway, that was Ape Escape 2, any percent. Yeah, what can I say more about it? I have a love-hate relationship with this game, but seeing the credits always cheers me up. Thank you. So next up is Jet Set Radio. The one, the only Flesh Iniqua who made all of the transitions on his own.